What's going on, YouTube? I am Will back here, and it's been a while, low key, man. I missed y'all. Did y'all miss me?
Hell no.
Okay, hey, it's cool. Don't worry. We got some decent stuff for you today, man. Yeah, school just been a, you know, it's been one of them things, but you know, like I said, I'm doing what I can, get out some content. So I decided today that I was gonna bring you another story. You know, if you kept up with the last one, I kind of started a little bit young. So this time I feel like I'm gonna step it up a little bit, go a little bit older. Got a nice little story for y'all today. But before you get ready to listen, you know, you gotta make sure you know subscribe to the channel, cause I'm gonna be dropping stuff like this. And there's gonna be more content that I've been working on that I'm gonna be pushing out soon. So, you know, if you wanna see what that's gonna be like, then go ahead and stick around. You know, are we gonna wait for the likes and dislikes and all that stuff? Cause if you don't like the story, alright, cool. So, today, what I'm gonna be talking about, and I think a lot of y'all can relate, whether it's with a female, with a male, whatever, yo, first. Is oh man, take me back, Lord, take me back. Oh man, look, so I ain't gonna lie to y'all, I don't even remember this story. Like I remember it, but like I don't remember everything that happened that led up to that point, but I do remember enough to tell the story, so that's what we gonna do. All right, check it. So I'm like 8 years old or something like that. And, you know, I've seen kissing before. Like, you know, I've seen my mom and my stepdad do it before. I've seen it on TV. You know, it's one of those things where when you see something, but you don't really know what to call it because you don't know the word or you don't know what it is. It's just like, oh, it's a thing in your head. You remember, that's how the brain works, you know. So, I see this stuff before and it's like, oh, okay, cool. You know, they doing this, they doing that. Okay. And that's just like the prior knowledge. Like this is me when I did know what it was, but I hadn't actually had a name for it. So me and my mom and my stepdad, we went to one of his friends, like I guess like not like an apartment, not with the apartment. It was just them. They was a crib. I think they had a crib. Low-key, yeah, a crib. Yeah, so like we went to a crib. And it was out in the suburbs, so if I remember correctly, it was like Plainfield or Plainview or something like that. I don't know who names this stuff that, but whatever, that's irrelevant. But it was going to one of those plain places, and his homie, he had like $3. Of course, he had $3. He has a house. He had $3, and they all were different ages. You know, they're not twins or anything like that. But one of them was like 14, maybe older. I don't know. One of them was way older. One of them was like my age, which was like 8, 9, 10. And then the other one was like 6 or 7 or something like that. So not too young or anything. But actually, you know what? Before I even go further, I'm going to say this right now. It wasn't with the oldest. That'd be a different conversation. We not talking about that this time. Not talking about this time. Alright. So, you know, we go there and it's like a little game night. They had, you know, it was just like pool for grown-ups, dominoes. That was a big thing that like my parents would play with their friends is dominoes. And then they just left us to roam around and do stuff. Oh yeah, my sister came too. And they just left us to roam around and do stuff. So my sister, she's, you know, hanging out with the youngest, and the oldest is just doing whatever she want to do. And I honestly had no clue what to do. Like I was sticking around the adults because I was like, okay, I'm familiar with my stepdad and my mama. You know, I'm just gonna watch them play dominoes or whatever. So I'm sticking around them, and I guess at some point they just told me to leave. Like I was low-key hurt because it's like, you know, I don't know what else to do. They're like, I ain't got nobody else to go around with or anything. So like, thought, Yeah, so I'm just sitting there, you know, they telling me to leave, and it's like, dang, because I guess they was finna start cursing or talking about some stuff that they ain't want my 8-year ears to hear or something. I don't know. But I walk off, and I'm just roaming the house, you know, like normal people do. I'm just roaming somebody else's house. And I'm going up the stairs and stuff, because it was two floors, and yeah, nice little house. I ain't gonna lie, at the basement, it was a little game room set up with the chairs and the couches, and it was a fish tank down there with the table. It was real decent, not gonna lie, it was real decent. And like, I just, you know, decided to walk up and down the stairs just to look. And I think what happened was I was going up the stairs, and I ran into the middle-aged daughter. Like I said, she was like 8, 9, 10, something like that. So she's either 2 years older than me, 1 year older than me, or she's the same age as me. So, and she looked like similar height to me. So I'm like, okay, you know, I'll see what's up. And like, one of the big things too was that I was like young, so I hadn't really interacted with a girl besides my sister and my mom. So it was like, oh my God, like this girl is just near me. I couldn't believe it. So I'm near this girl, you know, and I'm not gonna say names or anything like that, and to be honest, I probably couldn't because I don't remember it. But you know, she started talking to me, and she was like, you know, what's your name, and you know, like, why are you just walking up and down the stairs, because that's totally normal, you know, like. So we she's just talking to me and stuff, and I'm getting asked all these questions and shit, and, you know, like, I don't know what a interrogation is or anything like that, but I feel intimidated. So I'm kind of just like, I don't know, and my parents told me to leave. So, you know, I'm just telling her exactly what happened, but you know, I'm still nervous around her. I don't really know what's going on or anything like that. So she's like, oh, you know, okay, well, do you want to come play in my room? And me right now, if I would have heard that, I would have been like, ah, yeah. But, you know, I ain't know about none of that shit. So, you know, I'm like, okay, I guess, you know. And I was like, let me go ask my mom if it's okay. And she was like, oh, it's okay, it's fine, don't worry. My parents told me that, you know, we can just go in my room and do stuff if you got bored. And I'm like, okay, I'm not thinking that deep about it, but now that I actually talk about it, I'm like, wait, hold up, but you didn't even know my name. How do you ask for okay, all right, you know what, we're gonna keep going with the story. So, you know, we in the room, and I'm talking like it's like, you know, we was in college or something, but we in the room, and like, I was just sitting on the bed, and we was playing Uno. I think she had Uno or something. And, you know, we was playing Uno, and we was laughing and stuff, and I was like, this is going really good right now. I could not believe it. Could not believe it. Like, I'm really interacting with this girl. So, like I said, we playing Uno, and, you know, we just started doing stuff. I think at one point we played with some dolls. You know, I'm sorry, Mill, but I was playing with some dolls. Like, I didn't really know or care what I was doing. I was like, girl, what? So, I was like, okay. You know, we just doing stuff and all that, and then she was asking me how old was I, you know, general questions, and I told her how old I was, and you know, it's like, oh, okay, da, 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 and I'm asking questions back, so we just small talking, you know, and I honestly don't know what happened, but I think what happened was that we were gonna go switch and play with something else, and we ended up going and like, okay, so the way the room was, let me give you some context. The way the room was, it was like the bed was right near, like, as soon as you walked in, you could see the bed, and then it was like the dresser on the left side of it, and then it was like this openable closet on the left side of the dresser, so it'd be on the same side as the door, so you wouldn't be able to see the closet if you came in the room. So we going to the closet, and you can see where they're going. So, you know, we going to the closet, and I think we were like looking for Sorry or Monopoly or something like that, but I think we found something else first, not gonna lie, because what ended up happening was something completely different. What ended up happening is I'm next to her, and you know, it's kind of, you feel some tension. I ain't gonna lie, like, I still feel it right now. And I'm like, I don't know about this. And she was like, hey, you like surprises? I said, I mean, I guess. I'm like, sure, I do. And she was like, oh, okay, well, I got a surprise for you. Can you close your eyes real quick? And I'm like, bro, what is this girl finna do to me, bro? I was scared. I was like, bro, what type of magic she finna use on me? I was scared. Because when people tell you close your eyes, it's a lot of things that can happen. And from shows I had seen, I didn't know what was finna go down, man. I didn't know if I was gonna make it out that class, say real talk. But anyways, she tell me to close my eyes. And I'm like, okay, you know, I close my eyes with my eyes. I put my hands over my face. And she's like, take your hands down. You don't need to do that if your eyes closed. I'm like, yeah, you right. I'm just being goofy. So I took my hands down. And that's when it happened. That's when it happened. She gave me a 6, 7, 8 second kiss. I was like, oh my God. It was crazy, yo. Like, I ain't never had that happen before. And then low-key, like, I opened my eyes to see if it was really happening, because I couldn't believe it. And then she low-key was looking at me too, and then like she just closed my eyes. So that was kind of funny. And then low-key, bro, like, I'm not saying this is what was really gonna happen, but bro, I'm telling you, I was like 8 and she was like 10 or 8 years old or something like that, bro. But she knew something I ain't know. I was not in the loop. I did not know this was the plan coming into this crib, bro. I'm telling you, she grabbed my like back or something. She like was moving my hand, bro. I swear, I don't know what was finna happen in that closet, but I'm telling, like, something was finna go down. And it didn't happen because somebody knocked on the door. That's how it ended. Yep, somebody knocked on the door and ended my shine. Yep, So we just ended up hurrying out of the closet, and they heard us running, and somebody was like, I think it was a big sister, so we low-key could have kept going, but that didn't happen. We were scared, so she was like, oh, what are you guys doing? Oh, are you in the closet? And she's like, no, all that stuff, and I'm just standing there like, if only you knew. So yeah, that's pretty much it, man. I took my ass home and I was just thinking about her for the rest of the week, and then I never went over there again. Ain't that something? So yeah, that's how that was, man. But I hope y'all enjoyed the story, man. That was actually probably one of the more what am I talking about? I don't know. That was the story I want to tell the most. That's what I'm trying to say. That was the story I want to tell the most, and I was able to tell it. So I hope y'all enjoyed that. But like I said, stick around for some more stories. I definitely got a lot. I mean, I'm 21, so you know, I got a whole bunch of stories. But yeah, if you like the video, then go ahead and like and subscribe. You know, comment it. You know, if you want to see some different time period of my life, I got a lot. So you know, besides that though, I'm gone. Catch y'all later, man.